how to delete data first. Okay, to delete data, first file that you need to create is delete confirmation. So to delete, kita tak boleh instantly delete data. User press button then terus delete. Tak boleh macam tu. Kalau kita buat macam tu, kalau user tersilap tekan ke, dia memang tak boleh nak get back the data. Dia terus delete. To make more convenience to user, we need to create delete confirmation. It means if the user click delete, then it will prompt the user, do you want to delete the data? Create confirmation. The create confirmation ni to display again lah the information about the deletion of data tu. So we need the ID of the data. We have to connect to database lah. Use the select query to display data. Okay, to display data, we just display the important data. Tak perlu display all the data to make sure that, so dia data tu yang kita nak delete. Tak tertukar dengan data lain. Select, lepas tu execute query, display data. Then, barulah kita proceed to delete. To delete, we need another file, delete user. So delete user, example, create delete user.php. So inside the delete user.php, for sure we need a connection of database and retrieve the ID. Then proceed to delete. This one is delete lah. Create SQL, delete, execute. Okay, we start at display user. Okay, at the display user, add the second hyperlink. Kita buat satu lagi hyperlink untuk delete. Okay, href, kita buat confirm delete. Okay, .php. Okay, confirm delete.php will carry ID. Okay, so the value, use this value. Get the value. So this one is delete. Here we can see the delete hyperlink. So ada dua lah action, update dengan delete. Okay, now create confirm delete. Okay, confirm delete to retrieve data of ID. Ni macam to display again. Okay, firstly, make connection, get ID, select data. Okay, so fetch the data. Then assign to row, save as confirm delete. Okay, so ni get the data, then we need to display data. Okay, display data, we can display inside table. Okay, example, I want to display here. Okay, firstly, provide a title. Ni tanya soalan lah, nak confirm dia delete ke tak. Okay, the name and the value is, okay, how to get the value? Okay, the value inside this variable. We need to use PHP to get the value. So ataupun you can use this one to get the this one to display value. Ataupun you boleh buat guna echo. Echo, so data tu dah dalam row tribute name. Okay, sebab kita dapatkan information daripada database. So kita ambil attribute of the database lah. Okay, name. Okay, secondly the age. Okay, another way can avoid to use echo. Okay, macam ni. Macam ni je. Ada dua cara. Ni macam shortcut dia lah. First, dapatkan data dulu. Then, display. To make sure the user confirm delete. Okay, another thing. Provide the hyperlink. Okay, yang ni kita nak hantar kepada submit delete.php. So, you need to provide the ID. ID equal to. Okay, so you need to get the value. Delete user row user ID lah. User ID. Then press data ni. Delete. So dia akan open confirm delete.php. Example kalau kita tekan untuk delete Mahathir. So dia bawa lah data Mahathir. Macam mana dapat Mahathir ni? The ID lah. You need to carry the ID. Dengan ID ni barulah kita dapat selected data. Ni belum delete lagi. Nak confirm baru. Apa rational dia nak buat dan delete confirmation. Kita nak bagi user masa untuk fikir lagi lah. Kalau kita buat tekan terus delete pun boleh sebenarnya. Kita tekan terus delete. Boleh. Tapi kalau dia tersilap macam mana? Okay. So kita kena buat macam ni dulu. Delete confirmation. As usual, as other process. Sama je proses yang sebelum ni. You need to make a connection. Retrieve data ID ni. Okay, create SQL for delete. Okay, delete query. Execute the delete query. So, kita buat file delete user. Okay, dia punya proses dia. Lebih kurang je dengan submit tadi. Okay, this one save as delete user. Delete user.php. Okay, firstly make a connection, lepas tu get the information, the data. Okay, actually kita buat kat sini ada satu data je kita transmit, only the ID. Dapatkan ID saja. Then proceed to delete query. Delete from table name. Example, my table name is user. Lepas tu dah belakang dia kena ada where. Delete ni kita delete satu data. Yeah, delete from user where user ID. Kena put the ID, specific ID. Kalau kita tak letak where ni, habis semua data dan table sudah delete. So yang lain tu sama je. Diguna untuk execute the query. Use the MySQL query, MySQL LI query, DBC and the query connection and query. And provide the message. Ataupun you can redirect to list tadi. Pergi balik kepada list. Okay, for example kita buat macam ni dulu. So here, do you want to delete this data? Okay, delete user.php. Okay, so barulah dia hantar kepada file ni. Okay, then dia akan proceed to this file. Then delete. Lastly, display success or error. Kalau you perasan kat bawah dia display ID 1. Betul lah tu. Kita nak delete tu. Okay, proceed to delete. Record deleted successfully. Play again our list. So in the list tak ada lah yang first tadi kan. Abdul Wahad. Contoh kita pakai button. Okay, kita ganti dengan button. Gunalah button input type value. Dia keluar button. Ataupun nak guna image. Example saya guna ni hyperlink. So you can use any content lah. Nak guna text, image, button and so on. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.